Hi folks, this is all the fruit. I'm in the succulent garden, in the succulent botanic garden of Palanca on the Italian Riviera, on the Riviera di Ponente, near the town of Bordighera. This botanic garden is situated on the southern slopes of the ancient volcano Montenero. Actually, part of the botanic garden is carved into the soft volcanic rock. Very beautiful botanic garden if you like succulents and especially cacti. Not so beautiful if you like labels. As you can see here, lots and lots and lots of different species, but no labels. Less than 2 or 3% have labels. Well, this year, I remember it from my time in Arizona. We used to call it the pencil cholla. Cholla is the Mexican word for cylindropuntia, opuntia which don't have flat stems but cylindrical stems. And most of them are quite thick, like 2, 3, 4 centimeters thick, like over an inch thick. But this one, which is pretty thin, like stems which are 6 or so millimeters thick, like a pencil, is called pencil cholla. I don't know the Latin name, but I know it's the pencil cholla, I know it's edible. It's being marketed as a survival food for the desert. Well, I think that usually with such tiny cactus fruit, you waste more time and energy to harvest them and to remove the little glockets than they actually work, but we'll try it for the sake of the video. As you can see, what we call a fruit in opuntia is actually a part of the stem which contains the seeds, which first bears the flower and then contains the seeds. But here you can see that new young fruit are growing out of the old fruit, which makes it not a fruit, but a stem. Same with this here, as you can see. And here, as you can see, a lot of those opuntias, they multiply by, disattaching small branches, and then they grow into a new plant. The same thing works with those fruits. This is actually not a seedling, but just a new stem growing out of this stem, which looks like a fruit. Same thing here. Two new stems growing out of the fruit. Same thing here. Three new stems growing out of an unripe fruit. Well, here I removed one ripe fruit. The simplest way, not really the easiest, but the simplest way to remove the spines is to roll it around on the ground for some time. Well, not the spines, but the glockets. Basically a cactus. Here is a different cereus. A cactus has big spines and tiny glockets. The spines are basically, they correspond to leaves in normal plants and the glockets to hairs in normal plants. Here the same with the cholla. The spines are actually leaves. The tiny glockets, which you see mostly on the fruit, actually little hairs. So the fruit in this specific cholla, they have no spines, but they have glockets. So let's roll it around a bit. You can also roll it, carefully roll it inside the tissue or something. Just throw the tissue away after that. So I would say that this stuff is spineless, more or less spineless now. All the glockets should be on my fingers. Let's try it. Under the skin, under the reddish skin, is actually a lot more pale. Not very sweet, not very sour. A flavor which kind of resembles hawthorn. And hawthorn itself a little bit resembles apples. So the flavor remotely resembles apples. There's also a crunchiness in this fruit which kind of resembles apples. Well, okay. I didn't invest too much work in this fruit. I guess if you manage to disattach like 100 fruit and roll them around, they could be worth your trouble as a survival food or as a wild food in the desert. But still, There's a lot of oponche with bigger fruit, for example, this one fruit which fell from one of the oponche above. So, yeah, when in the desert, pencil choya wouldn't be my first choice for fruit foraging, but it is possible to harvest it and to remove the glochids and to be able to eat it. So, folks, this was the pencil choya from the Mexican and Arizona deserts. Stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos from beautiful Italian Riviera. And don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.